Good Morning Bay Street is a production of TheUptrend.com and is for information and educational purposes only. The views and opinions expressed in this presentation are those of Stephen Whiteside and should not be considered personal investment advice. Always consult a qualified financial advisor before making any investment decisions. To learn more about the charts featured in this presentation, please visit theuptrend.com. And now, here is Stephen Whiteside with today's newsletter.
Good morning, Steve Whiteside here with your daily market outlook for Thursday, April 1st, 2010. In the pre-market on Thursday morning, we've got stock index futures above fair value. Gold, crude oil are all up in the pre-market. European and Asian markets were up overnight. So we are going to see a bounce at the open on Thursday morning. Now, typically the day before a long weekend is positive. We also have all the end of month pension and retirement money coming into the stock market on the first of the month. So we are expecting a positive day on Thursday. So one of the most common questions I get is, how much time do I need to spend analyzing my charts each night? And I think you should spend a lot of time developing your portfolios and picking out the stocks and ETFs that you want to follow on a regular basis. You've got to turn this from being a game into a business and start putting the pieces together of the things that you want to follow. I don't get up every morning looking for new stocks to chase. I don't try to match up the headlines with charts. I'm not event reactive. I am waiting for the stocks and ETFs that I follow to do things over time. I'm not expecting them to do things today. Now, on any given day, there's really nothing to do. 9 out of 10 days, you don't have a lot to do. Now, on those days where we get a lot of volatility, the TSX is up or down over 200 points, you might have some additional work. If the all the major indexes give buy or sell signals at the same time, then I might have to spend about 20 minutes looking at my charts. But if I'm spending more than 20 minutes a night looking at my charts, I'm basically wasting my time. I'm not going to make more money by spending more time looking at the same charts. Now, I'm going to scan through the TSX 60 this morning. I'm going to stop and chat about a couple of the charts, but for the most part, 60 stocks should take you 60 seconds. And basically, I don't need to explain to you what the stocks are that are in the TSX 60. I've sorted these by sector. So Bombardier comes up first as an aerospace company. There's nothing to do here. There's no new signal. So the stock is still in an uptrend. Nothing to do here. Nothing to do here. So bang, bang, bang. I'm just going through. Now, I just want to talk about bank stocks for a second. There's nothing to do with bank stocks on Thursday morning, but we were expecting some weakness last week. We're starting to see that. We're starting to see red on some of the charts. We're starting to see some of the stocks trade down to the lower channel line. In fact, two of the six stocks have already given sell signals, and that's CIBC and the National Bank. Royal Bank's looking weak, but hasn't given a sell signal, and TD's looking strong at the present time. Nothing to do on Thursday morning. Continue through the TSX 60. I'm looking for things to do. Now, along the way, there's some things to note. If you wanted to continue to short Shaw, it traded up and down. So if you're looking for a trend change in Shaw, it traded up to the upper channel line and down to the lower channel line yesterday. And so there's a little extra volatility there. And so which way is it going to go next? Is it going to generate a new buy signal or a new sell signal? Now, one stock we have to do something with, Research in Motion, generated a sell signal as of Wednesday's close. Of course, it traded sharply lower after hours. We'll have to see how that turns out. But here is a stock that we actually have to do something about if you own Research in Motion. I don't own it at the present time. We talked about the fact that it was up at the top of the panic zones last time it gave a sell signal. Would I continue with that trade? And the answer was no. And I said no to the previous trade before that as well. So, you know, all the easy money is made off the bottom of the panic zones when the stock first starts to run. Once it gets up here, it's much harder to make money at the top of the panic zones. Taking a look, keep scanning, anything to do, anything to do, anything to do, nothing to do, nothing to do, nothing to do, gold stocks. Gold's up sharply this morning. We're looking for buy signals in the gold sector. And in the TSX 60, we've got one buy signal. Intimate Mining gave a buy signal last night as of the close, but the rest of the major gold stocks have not. Just because gold is going up does not mean gold stocks have to go up, and when gold goes down, that does not mean that gold stocks have to go down as well. Little weakness in Loblaws, didn't close below the lower channel line. Metro still in a downtrend. We're looking for changes here. Taking a look at Aeroplan, if you're short Aeroplan and you're looking to cover that short, we ran up to the upper channel line yesterday. So that's just something you would note that, hey, we're seeing a little strength in Aeroplan. I might have to cover this short position in the next couple of days. Nothing to do in yellow pages, continue lower, nothing to do in insurance. The trends are still the same. Oil and gas, they're up yesterday. Crude oil's up again on Thursday morning. So anybody who's long these stocks, no problems there. Continuing, looking for trend changes, nothing, railroad stocks. So here's our second trade. Tim Hortons generated a sell signal as of Wednesday's close. So if you own Tim Hortons, you need to sell it at the open on Thursday morning. But otherwise, we're going through here and there's no other trend changes. So there you have it. We just went through 60 stocks very quickly, only two stocks that we have to deal with. If you own those stocks, if you don't own them, then you have nothing to do on Thursday morning. Taking a look at some other charts from Wednesday's trading activity, we saw some weakness in the financial sector, so we're down to the lower channel line in the Horizon Beta Pro Bull ETF, up to the upper channel line in the Horizon Beta Pro Bear ETF for the financial sector. Still no reason to end that trade. The TSX Financial Services Index came down to the lower channel line. Again, we do not have a sell signal to cause you to do anything on Thursday morning. Canadian dollar gave a buy signal as of the close on Wednesday. Crude oil is up. We'll have to see if we can go through the January highs. Copper is still trading above the January highs, so copper is still doing okay. Nothing going on with natural gas. A daily close above 415 on Thursday would give us a buy signal. And moving over, taking a look at the 60-minute charts for Thursday's trading activity. Looking at the 60-minute flypaper channel, the TSX ended the day on Wednesday right in the channel. If we start breaking down below 11,980 on Thursday, that would tell us that the bears are in control. For financial stocks, we came right down to the flypaper channel. If we start breaking below, then you would start to see some more daily sell signals in that sector. Energy sector ran right through the flypaper channel the other day. That's why we're seeing buy signals in that sector. Still waiting for gold stocks. If we start breaking out above 318, then you're going to start to see more daily buy signals in the gold sector. And for material stocks, if we start breaking out above 333 on Friday, that would probably equate to some more buy signals on the daily charts in that sector. That's all for Thursday morning. Friday, of course, everybody's closed. It's a long weekend. I'm also taking Monday off, so the next time you'll hear from me is Tuesday morning at this time. So have a great day, have a great weekend, and we'll talk to you next week.
That was Stephen Whiteside with today's Good Morning Bay Street newsletter. For more information on our charts and services, please visit theuptrend.com.